What's up, everyone? It's Flynn Patrick once again, live from my couch. And in this video, I am super excited because we are introducing a new series, and this is called the NBA Rookie Ladder. So what we're going to do is at a lot of points during the season, we are going to go over the top rookies in the NBA. And some of these dudes are absolute stud muffins, for real though. Anyways, we've gotten an early look at how some of these players look, and I'm going to give a couple of notes before we introduce the rookie ladder. Number one, there are a lot of good players in this class. I feel that the 2017 rookie class was honestly one of the deepest of all time. It was also top heavy with guys like Ben Simmons, Donovan Mitchell, Jason Tatum, even Kyle Kuzma. I don't think that this class is as top heavy, but I do think that this class is as deep, and I think that there are some players who are going to make an immediate impact. So in further editions, we're probably going to expand to 25 rookies, but in our first edition, we're going to start with the top 15 rookies. We haven't gotten a big enough sample size yet to get to 25, I feel like, but I do think that these players are the clear top 15 rookies right now, and I'm really excited to talk about these young guys and the impact that they are going to have this upcoming season. Before we get started, I have put these rookies in tiers. I have put them in four tiers. We will go over those really quickly. Tier four is solid role players. I think that these players are probably not going to be stars next year, but I do think that they will have a positive impact for their team. Tier three is the surprises. Tier number two, this is the biggest tier, immediate impact players. As I said, I think this class is just as deep as last year, and I think that there are some players who are going to make an immediate impact. This tier has the most amount of players. I think that there are a lot of rookies who are ready to make an immediate impact right now. I'm really excited to see what these players do. And finally, tier number one, the stud muffins. There are two players in this tier. If you have followed the NBA preseason whatsoever, it's probably pretty obvious who these two players are. Anyways, let's get right to it. First, I'm just gonna show a list of the players to watch out for. I've made an initial top 25 ranking. We're just not going to go over 16 through 25 in detail. But one player specifically who was undrafted, who is looking surprisingly good so far, is Alonzo Trier, or Trier, I don't know how to pronounce it, but he came out of the University of Arizona, and he is absolutely balling out for the New York Knicks in the preseason so far. I would be absolutely surprised if he did not make the team at this point. He's been scoring like crazy, and I could see him being one of the biggest surprise rookies in all of the NBA if he continues to play the way he has. So we're starting with tier number four. Without further ado, let's get to the top 15. Our number 15 rookie on the initial edition of our rookie ladder is Dante DiVincenzo of the Milwaukee Bucks. He's been struggling shooting the ball so far. That being said, looking at the box scores and watching the games a little bit, he is having a positive impact on the floor when he is on the floor for this Bucks team. He's a good shooter. I feel like his shooting will improve. But the good news is the other areas of his game are looking pretty good so far. He plays solid defense, and he knows how to be a team player, and he's willing to play his role. I'm not sure he finishes too much higher than this throughout the season. He is having a positive impact on the floor when he's on the floor for this Bucks team. So Dante DiVincenzo, congrats for cracking our initial top 15. Our number 14 player on our initial rookie ladder is going to be Chandler Hutchinson of the Chicago Bulls. Not flashy, but I liked him coming out of college. I was high on him. I think that he's a good fit for this Bulls team as a second string forward coming off the bench. He's played pretty decently so far. Again, not really a flashy player by any means, but we're at the point in the ranking where these players aren't exactly going to be stars. And I think Chandler Hutchinson has looked pretty decent for the Chicago Bulls so far. He's made an overall positive impact, and I think he will be a solid role player for this Bulls team this upcoming season. All right, we're getting to tier number three. This tier has three players, and these are players who I think have exceeded expectations so far in the preseason. And our number 13 player is going to be Landry Shamet of the Philadelphia 76ers. If you followed my channel throughout the draft process, it was very obvious that I was and still am very high on Zaire Smith. He might miss the whole season. That being said, he's still 19 years old. I still think he's going to be a really solid NBA player. But the injury to Zaire Smith has opened up an opportunity for Landry Shamet to jump into the 76ers rotation, and he looks really, really solid on offense so far, and he has exceeded expectation. His shot is NBA ready. He still needs to gain some strength, but from watching him, it looks like he has gained some strength. He looks like he gained about 5 or 10 pounds at least from the time the draft ended. So he's obviously been putting in the work, and he's been shooting very efficiently so far. This is a 76ers team that has high aspirations, and if Landry Shamet can make an immediate impact on this team that is likely going to have a lot of success this upcoming season, Landry Shamet could jump up our ranking quickly. Next up, number 12, we have Grayson Allen of the Utah Jazz. He is a good fit for this Jazz team. He was drafted outside of the top 20, but I feel like he has exceeded expectations a little bit as well. He has a winning mentality. He's a good fit for this team. He's an exciting player to watch, and he has swag. He has a demeanor that is very valuable for this Jazz team. I think he's going to get a lot of playing time early on that second string unit, and I think Grayson Allen is ready to make an immediate impact. Our number 11 player is going to be Shai Gilgeous-Alexander of the LA Clippers. And this is a player I feel like could move up this ranking if he continues playing the way he has. This dude looks really, really good. He looks a lot more advanced than I thought he would have. His all-around game looks solid. Again, he's got size. I mentioned in the Clippers preview that he could have an impact, and man, he looks really, really good. He's got the passing, he's got the defense, he's got a ridiculous basketball IQ for his age. I think Shai Gilgeous-Alexander could low-key be like a top 100-ish type player by the time he's around 22 years old. All right, we're jumping into the top 10, and our next tier is going to be players who I think will make an immediate impact. I have already put these players in the top 200 overall players. Let's get right to it. Number 10 is going to be Colin Sexton of the Cleveland Cavaliers. Could shoot it a little bit more efficiently, but he is going to have every single opportunity to get a lot of touches this upcoming season. LeBron James is obviously no longer on this team, so Cavaliers fans are going to be super excited to see how Colin Sexton does. He plays really hard, which NBA fans saw in the summer league, and Colin Sexton is ready to go for it all, brother man dude. All right, these next two players, they're ranked number 8 and number 9 respectively, but they have ridiculous long-term potential, and I feel like they could move up this ranking fast if they continue playing the way they have. Number 9, Mohamed Bamba of the Orlando Magic. He has only played 2 preseason games, but he looks very advanced for his age. It looks like that the Magic found the center of their future. Again, they've got a weird situation because Nikola Vucevic is still on the team and he is going to be the starting center for now. Bamba is in a nice situation in Orlando where he's going to have opportunities to develop his game this upcoming season without there being too much pressure. His shot looks more advanced than we thought. His defense is ridiculous. He's got the longest wingspan in the NBA, if I'm not mistaken. And Mohamed Bamba could be a top 100 overall player by the time 2020 rolls around. At number 8, we have Jaren Jackson Jr. of my Memphis Grizzlies. And he looks ridiculous in the low post so far. And as a Grizzlies fan, I think the Grizzlies made a great draft pick in Jaren Jackson Jr., which I didn't necessarily say at first, but the more I watched him play in the summer league, I was like, good golly gee Wilkers, this guy is an absolute stud muffin. They did a survey from the NBA GMs, and I believe he tied with either DeAndre Ayton or Luka Doncic. I forget who it was, but he was tied for number 1 on the player GMs thought would be the best long-term. So that really excites me about this guy. He might not be a top 100 player this upcoming season. He probably won't. But this guy could end up being Kevin Garnett with a jump shot. I know that's a ridiculous statement to make, but if he stays healthy, he has ridiculous long-term skills. I'm really, really excited as a Grizzlies fan to see what Jaren Jackson Jr. can do. At number 7, we have Trae Young of the Atlanta Hawks. He's going to get plenty of opportunities to score. Right now, I have him barely above Jaren Jackson Jr. and Mohamed Bamba. If the current trend continues, I could see Jaren Jackson Jr. and Mohamed Bamba probably moving ahead of him, but for now, Trae Young is number 7. He could shoot it a little more efficiently, but He has made some nice plays in the preseason so far. He is obviously going to get plenty of opportunities to score on this Atlanta Hawks team. Trae Young cracks our list at number 7. At number 6, we have Wendell Carter Jr. of the Chicago Bulls. He did get dunked on by Jahlil Okafor. That is a little bit of a down. That being said, he's a good rebounder. He has a high basketball IQ. He is not the flashiest player, but he looks really good so far. I think Wendell Carter Jr. is going to be a really, really solid NBA player for a long time as long as he stays healthy. All right, these next two players are going to be some big surprises so far. Number 5, Kevin Knox of the New York Knicks. He is getting a lot of praise. He got praise from players like Anthony Davis and Julius Randle, and he looks really good so far. I was not high on the draft pick at the time. I am looking wrong right now. Kevin Knox has length. He has a nice small forward body. He has good athleticism. And with Porzingis out for the Knicks, Kevin Knox is going to have a lot of opportunities to do his thing for this Knicks team. He's getting praise from NBA veterans, and Kevin Knox is ready to make an impact for this Knicks team that is looking for excitement. Number 4, this is a big surprise, Miles Bridges of the Charlotte Hornets. His first couple of preseason games, he looked absolutely ridiculous. Good golly gee Wilkers, those putback dunks he had absolutely blew my mind. He kind of tuned it down in the third preseason game, and I might be jumping the boat a little bit on how high I have him. The hype died down on him a little bit throughout the draft process because I guess he wasn't a freshman, but he is looking really good. Charlotte looks like they made the right decision so far. He could even be in the starting lineup. Miles Bridges starts our rookie ranking at number 4. Congrats to him. So at number 3, we have a player who quite simply needs to improve or he's going to fall in this ranking. But I did give him a little bit of leeway because he was the number 2 pick, and I think he's a really talented player. So number 3 is going to be Marvin Bagley III. He put up 19-10 against Golden State. I mean, I don't really know what Sacramento's doing with him. I mean, they really should have drafted Luka Doncic, I think. I mean, they played him at shooting guard, which, I mean, whatever floats your boat, Sacramento. I do think Marvin Bagley III is very talented. I have him cracking our top 150 players right now. But again, as I said, he needs to continue playing solid or else some of these players below him will probably jump ahead of him in the ranking. All right, let's get right to it. These two players who are in our top 2 are absolute stud muffins. I already have them as top 75 players in the NBA. That's how talented I think they are going to be this upcoming season. And I think they could be potential stars fairly quickly. And it should be fairly obvious to anyone who's followed the NBA who these two players are. Number 2, Luka Doncic. Dude is just 19 years old, way ahead of the curve in terms of basketball IQ. I am very impressed. I love Jaren Jackson Jr. as a Grizzlies fan, but I do wish sometimes that the Grizzlies were able to get Luka Doncic. This guy is going to be a really, really good player for Dallas for a long time, as long as he stays healthy. Dirk Nowitzki is on the verge of retiring, so this guy is primed to take over as the face of this Dallas franchise, and I am really excited to see what this good all-around player can do in Dallas this upcoming season. And the number one pick, DeAndre Ayton. This dude looks absolutely ridiculous. I already have him as a top 60 player right now. Devin Booker might not be playing to start the season, although he did say today that he wants to play at the start of the season, but DeAndre Ayton looks absolutely ridiculous. He is an impact player right now. He could even be like a top 30-ish player by the time the end of the season comes. I mean, I'm sure he'll have some rookie struggles and there's ups and downs in whatever you do, but man, this guy looks absolutely scary. He looks like he was worth the number 1 pick, and DeAndre Ayton is going to be an absolute force of nature stud muffin for the Phoenix Suns this upcoming season. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'm really excited to start the series. I think it's going to be a fun time, and we're going to be talking about these rookies a lot throughout the upcoming season. My name is Flynn Patrick. We will be back with more content shortly.